Welcome to this brief introduction to Infor Document Management. Infor Document Management can be used to store, create, and capture documents for your business needs. In this first video of the series, we will be focusing on a couple of the setting configurations to help you understand how documents in IDM are linked to a record with applications. To begin viewing and updating the settings and configurations for Infor Document Management, you can access the Control Center by clicking on the gear wheel at the top right corner of the screen. This will take you to a new screen where you have access to the various menu options needed to review or make any changes. One thing you may notice is that the menu options are available on the main screen and on the left side menu. This will provide you quick navigation to a specific area from the start, while you can always access the left side toolbar from any screen within the Control Center. Let's begin by accessing the document type found under the Administration section. A document type is a template for defining and later locating similar items. From our list of document types, we can use a search bar to locate a specific document. In this case, let's search for purchase orders. From the General tab, we can view basic information such as display name and document title. The Attributes tab will show the fields used to locate a document. And within each attribute, you can view or configure details, including the display name, any defaulting values, or if the attribute is required or not. An attribute can store units of measure or metadata, values that describe a certain characteristics or properties of a document. The next tab is ACL, or the Access Control List. This list defines which users have access to the current document type. ACLs are the sets of user roles and privileges. By opening the Roles List panel, this will display a grid of roles along with what actions that role is allowed to take on that specific document type. These actions can include read-only, edit, create, delete, check in and out, or some higher level admin actions as well. You may notice that all the roles here are delivered standard template roles. If you have defined specific roles for your organization, you can add those roles to the roles list here from the dropdown located at the bottom of the list. Any user role created in Landmark are synchronized with IFS and will show up in the dropdown menu. Now let's take a look at the Business Context Model, which can be found under the Configuration Model option. You can use the Business Context Model to create a rule that can link documents in IDM to a screen in the ERP. When I view the list here, I can look for the screen name and the document type combination that I want to create the rule for. When I select the record, I can review the key information including the screen name and the document type, but I also want to review the X query as well. This query is used to show the documents for the selected screen. In this case, I am looking for a company attribute that is the same as the value of ID1 and a purchase order attribute that is the same as the value of ID2. When these values of the purchase order match the values of the document attributes, this is what links the two together. So where do you find where these ID1 and ID2 attributes are listed? By going into the purchase order record, I can access the Contextual Viewer Contextual app. Here I can see the screen name, and if I scroll down a little further, I can see where the attributes are linked to the purchase order company and the purchase order number. That concludes this video. In a future video, we will review how to utilize the IDM Contextual app to attach documents to a record, along with some of the other features that this app can provide.